So, game at number two here. We're going to see what the map that Squirtle selects, or rather, Pet selects, excuse me. It's going to be Daedalus Point. We did learn, if you were watching earlier, that Daedalus is the mythical character who was the father of Icarus.
Supposedly mythical.
Supposedly mythical.
I don't think we have proof
him
either way.
Him and Santa, you know, we're, you know, not entirely sure.
No.
He also made the labyrinth the Minotaur was in.
Yeah.
That's a lot of hard work. Think about that, to make a labyrinth.
Yeah, that would be pretty tough to make a labyrinth.
It's not like people that go to labyrinths, they don't get to experience all the nice parts of it. They basically just get lost in there for a very long time.
Yeah, and perhaps die, and they might even end up hating the labyrinth, but really hate yourself for not being able to find your way out.
I'll bring in a ball of string.
Yeah.
What happened? He uses the ball of string to escape after he kills the Minotaur, right?
I don't know. I don't remember. Like, it's so
long since
I heard
how big would a labyrinth really have to be to actually get lost in it? Like, to the point where you'd be concerned about starving, because I would just figure that
eventually you just find your way out.
I live in Hongdae, man. That's a giant labyrinth.
Well, it's dark in labyrinths, right?
That's true. It
and if
dark.
It's, like, pitch black, imagine being deep in one. It's like...
I wouldn't go in. Hell no.
Well, what if you have to slay a Minotaur?
I'd bring a mining helmet or something.
There was no mining helmets back then. Your fire went out. Now what? You slayed the Minotaur. You're wounded. You're grievously wounded because it was a Minotaur. And the fact that you could kill him means you're a hero.
First of all, the fact that Tasis could kill a Minotaur. I don't think Tasis could manage to kill a medium-sized dog.
That may be true.
The fact that I already killed a Minotaur.
I could probably kill a Minotaur, but you know, probably not. I've seen you try to dribble a basketball. That Minotaur would just... he would have his way with you, Tasis.
Yeah, man.
You'd probably walk in and, like... Oh, I don't even know. The Minotaur would laugh. He wouldn't even kill you. He'd let you go.
He'd make me give him his... I had to give him my wallet or something. I'm like, oh, come on, man. All my cards are in there. All right. Game number two here between Pet and Squirtle in the GSL Code S.
Pet versus Squatter.
The Pet fans... Once again, going wild.
It's so funny, the Minotaur would laugh and just let me go.
Yeah.
It's so
well, he's
funny.
Like, why would he, you
he's
know.
Like, get out of here, man.
That would, the Minotaur killing you would be like.
Minotaur is just.
A bullhead on a man.
Bullhead on a man. It's yeah, okay, bullhead on a man.
Yeah.
It's like I know what a Minotaur looks like, but I'm like, what exactly is the definition? Because he also has like. Well, bullhead on a man, then he has bull legs, right? He has the torso of a male with hands.
Okay, yeah, I think you're right.
Yeah, and I believe he has the, that's what I was getting.
Yeah, I believe so.
But it's hard to tell. I mean, he might be wearing pants. Some Minotaurs might go for pants, in which case, you know, you don't really get the full Minotaur experience.
But, I mean, you'd probably get, like, your fur would get all greasy and stuff because you're, like, sweating in there. You know,
well, I mean, it really depends
legs.
On your
the climate
weight mechanism of Minotaur fashion, really.
Well, I don't think it's even a fashion question. I think it's like, there's going to be a certain amount of heat that the pants keep in that your fur is actually trying to let off because, you know, animals have fur to keep them warm.
And yet humans still dress them up in silly clothes.
That's true.
Oh, my God. They're hurling the Zerg in there.
Yeah, that's the lurker,
like,
man.
Solky, come save me. Ah!
He's like, I just want to make this game fun.
Stay in there, Lurker.
Stay in there, Lurker. You're not going to be
in Legacy of the Void?
No, Lurker, shut up. You're in use maps and single player only.
What are they doing to him?
He's torturing
him. He's clearly not sedated.
Huh, why would you sedate him? Lurkers don't have souls.
He's like trying to probe. It's not happening. That he's already underground.
That probe is disgusting. He's just watching this happen.
It's Lurker smut.
He's like, meow, I don't care.
I never learned how to feel.
Yeah.
Programmed to feel.
He's probably a sociopath.
Whoa, nice one. We're on a killing spree right now.
All right, so. I'm actually quite disturbed to continue to watch this Lurker get completely tortured. You know, Lurkers did a lot of stuff to me in StarCraft 1, so I'm actually completely
You're actually
fine
okay
with this.
For this one poor Lurker.
Well, this one poor Lurker, I'm like, oh yeah, how's that feel, yeah? I think you killed enough of my Marines. He's like, I'm a different Lurker. I'm actually a peaceful Lurker.
It wasn't my fault to stop position or hold position bug work in Brood War.
By the way, this is a one base Stargate out of Squirtle. Of course, we see it's a proxy Stargate, but just the fact that he's doing it off one base right now, Pet's brain should be going wild because there's no Nexus yet. Like, this is, he knows something weird is up. And of course, he's already getting speed because it is Daedalus point, so that just makes sense.
That Oracle now being Chrono boosted out here.
Indeed. I'm surprised he's not doing more. Like, okay, he's just adding a third base. Here's the thing. I think Pet might just be like so young and new and like still getting skill. You know, like still building himself.
I mean, granted, all his friends came down here. This is a totally radical experience to play on TV with all your people you know watching. And of course, if you're all good enough to make it all the way to Code S, then clearly you really like this game and play this game a lot, and all your friends are here to support you.
Look, okay, still no Nexus. He's making a second Oracle. This is the type of strategy that I would expect, like, a C-rate foreigner to try against a Korean pro in a tournament. Like, someone that, like, is not even, you know, just someone that would never win a tournament. I feel like this is, you sit there, make two Oracles off one base, and then your Nexus. But the thing is, it's going to probably work here very well, because there's two queens total. So, this is just showing the inexperience of Pet. A very good player, of course, but still very new. And, this much damage is, this is a ton of damage. This is something that should have been predictable. And
well, I mean, you would expect something, right?
Well, he sees there's no Nexus. This isn't like rocket science or something, right? This is, something is happening.
And now hitting the drones that are getting pulled out now.
Yeah. So the rest of this game is going to be kind of weird because Pet does have three hatches. Squirtle has no Nexus at his natural. He's just making some gates. I guess that's okay.
This does not look like what a Code S game is normally.
No, but I think that Squirtle has actually, I think it's okay what he's done here, which is so funny because normally what would happen is he's doing this strategy, and even though it doesn't get scouted, the Zerg sees there's no hatchery and just prepares by making extra queens, making some lings, making a spore in case it's DTs, and then Squirtle's strategy doesn't work and he dies because he has one base. But I guess this is okay because he's identified that Pet, like, isn't really thinking that much in these games. He might be under a lot of pressure. He's a new player.
He's been a bit of a robot.
And the thing is, game one, you can actually extrapolate from game one that this type of thing could happen because he just kept making, like, layer compositions and sending them across the map.
It's like he was, you know, I mean, playing StarCraft is a lot like, you know, dancing. I mean, if your partner's doing the tango, you can't do the waltz, and that's sort of what we were seeing Pet do here. But now the Lings are coming in here. This is looking like a weird, like, season one of Wings of Liberty game, just plus hard swarm units.
It's definitely, it's a very weird one. And, like, I actually don't even know who's going to win still. You would think that Squirtle would just win because he's killed so many drones, but, like, Squirtle's economy is very slow. He is losing some probes here and there. Pet now has a ton of information, right?
Right.
Killed off the Stargate, and he sees that this guy's probe light. He's on three gates, got some sentries. Obviously, this has to be a sentry timing attack. Most likely just gateway units. So all he needs to really do is prepare for that. And if he can hold that, Squirtle is still sitting here with a completely garbage economy.
Well, Squirtle's going to move out now, try to apply some pressure. We have 10 lings being made. Not clear how much more the Zerg has. Beyond that, the Roachhorn is halfway done. So with the Zealots and just the Sentries, and actually with the Oracle support here too.
Yeah, it's pretty scary. He's got one queen. The Oracles themselves can kill everything except for the spores.
Yeah, and with the number of Sentries that are out, he can make it so that the Lings will always have an unfavorable engagement.
Yeah. It's a dirty game. Chase is down and dirty. Happy Valentine's Day, everyone.
Now, I got to say, his sentries are not exactly bunched up properly, but that might not matter here. These drones can't really get out. And I think we're going to have GG here.
Yeah, I would think so, but
I believe we have GG here, yeah.
There's just way too much here. Oracles were pretty hero.
It's funny because you would expect Pet to scout that properly or be more prepared, but he just wasn't.
Well, he basically did scout it, right? It's just the Pet needs more experience.
I guess what I'm saying is react properly.
Yeah, well, react in any way.
take in the intel, think about it, and then use that to respond in a more efficient manner.
Yeah, yeah. But you know what? This is oftentimes what like a brand new programmer looks like against a complete veteran like Squirtle.
GG.
And Squirtle easily advances. 100% Pet is going to lose to Sora. There is not even a chance in the universe that this guy is going to come out of this group when he's like his nerves, his newness, any whatever the reason may be.
I'm wondering how many of his friends in the audience are actually StarCraft guys versus just buddies from school. Because, you know, if he's got his StarCraft friends there, maybe he gets some, you know, kind of hands-on coaching, hands-on help.
He's on StarTail, so he should be able to get some help. But,
You know,
I think it's a nerve issue more than anything, because the fact that he's in Code S shows that he's better than what he's showing here.
Yeah.
But, you know, you're on the big stage, you're playing against Squirtle, who's been in a GSL Finals. Like,
yeah, talk about a guy that's had a lot of
experience. Can't expect him to play well right there. And
yeah.
I hope no one at home holds it against Pet that he played like that. Like, I'm sure in
experience is key.
Yeah, in some other tournaments and stuff, he's going to look much, much better.
This is a good
it's
way to learn.
Eventually.
You got to play on stage eventually, and the more you do it, like anything else, you're going to improve. We're going to take a short little break. When we come back, we're going to go to the winners' match and see who's going to be the first to get out of Group D in today's GSL Code S. Stay tuned.
Echoes you can feel and rehearse the